No, ortho were triad of unit vectors and components of a vector. So we define three unit vectors which are orthogonal. Orthogonal means perpendicular, mutually perpendicular, and also they are unit vectors. Three such vectors we define. For this, consider the coordinate system, three dimensional coordinate system. That is the coordinate with the coordinate axis, x axis, y axis, and z axis. Three mutually perpendicular axes. So the x axis, the y axis, and the z axis. This OX, x axis, OY, y axis, OZ, z axis. Or more precisely, these are the positive directions of the x, y, and z axis. And now consider unit distance along these three axes, x axis, y axis, and z axis. This distance, suppose this is OA, OB, and OC. OA, OB, OC. OA equal to OB equal to OC, which is unit distance in length. Now consider a vector. With this OA as magnitude and direction along the positive direction of the axis. So this is a unit vector along the positive direction of the x axis. It is usually denoted by the symbol small I with a cap unit vector. And this vector with unit magnitude and direction along positive direction of the y axis. It's a unit vector along the positive direction of the y axis. Denoted by small j with a cap. And similarly, this vector along positive direction of the z axis usually denoted by the small k with a cap. Thus, we have three unit vectors, one I, another j, and the third k. These three are unit vectors along positive directions of the x, y, and z axis. And therefore, since the axes are mutually perpendicular, these three vectors are mutually perpendicular. So three vectors, triad of vectors, mutually perpendicular, mutually orthogonal, perpendicular, orthogonal. So we have three orthogonal triad of three vectors, orthogonal unit vectors. That is triad of orthogonal vectors along positive directions of the x, y, and z axis. So that is the definition of these orthogonal triad of vectors. They are vectors, unit vectors, along positive directions of the x, y, and z axis. Okay, and now then components of a vector. Components means if we have any vector in space, that vector can be written as a linear combination of these triad of vectors I, j, and k. I, j, and k. For example, consider a vector OP in space. That is R. If this vector is somewhere else in the space, then we can replace that vector here as OP without altering its magnitude and direction. If the magnitude and direction are not changed, these two vectors are the same. So any vector in space can be replaced here without altering its magnitude and direction. So place that vector here. We can show that this vector R can be written as a linear combination of this I, j, and k. That is, the sum of this vector R can be written as the sum of scalar multiples of this I, j, and k. Linear combination means scalar multiples of the sum of I, j, and k. Okay? So, we can prove that, or we can find the sum as the linear combination of I, j, and k. For this, we rewrite this diagram. So, first you consider a rectangular box with the OP as one diagonal. OP, the vector has one diagonal. The vector has one diagonal. So this is O, OX, OY, and OZ. This is the OY. So here we have this I, a J, and a K. And this diagonal of this vector, which is OP, the vector OP, as diagonal of this rectangular box. So construct such a box. It is possible. Construct such a box. And now, these three adjacent sides of this box are, one is this. This. And the other side is this. And the next is this. Three adjacent sides. Which is, suppose this. OYL. OM, ON, three adjacent sides, edges of the box. And now, here we have a unit vector I, and therefore, this vector OL, OL can be written as some vector in some constant x into I. The magnitude is OL is equal to x. I is unit vector. So this OL vector is this x into I. Okay. Similarly, this OM, vector OM is equal to some constant y into k. This OM and this j are collinear. So this much distance OM can be taken as y. So this vector OM is y into j. Similarly, this ON is equal to some z into k, y into j, z into k. And now consider this OP over this vector R. Vector R is equal to this OL, vector OL, plus L, say this is equal to Q. LQ plus QP. You can write this R in this form. Vector addition, method. This OL plus LQ plus QP. This is equal to OP. OP which is R. And no, OL is equal to XI plus LQ, which is same as this OM, vector OM. These sides are equal, so direction same, LQ, this OM. This is a rectangular box, so which is equal to this YJ plus this ON is equal to this QP, opposite edges of the rectangular box. Direction same, QP, this ON. So which is equal to this ON, which is equal to Z. XI, YJ, Z. That is, this vector R can be written as XI plus YJ plus Z. And in this situation, this XI, YJ, and ZK, these three are called the components of the vector R. Vector components of the given vector R, the given vector OP. Components. And these constants x, y, z are known as the scalar components of the vector or rectangular components of the vector. Scalar components or rectangular components of the vector are OP. Xi, yj and zk. These vectors are the components or vector components of the vector, the given vector R, are equal to OP. So this is the definition. And this type of representation is possible for all vectors in the space. And therefore, sometimes a vector in space can be represented in this form. Xi plus yj plus zk. Where x, y, z are constants. And again, remember, this distance yl is x, this distance om is y, and this distance yn is z. And these three x, y, z are the coordinates of this point x, y, p. X, y, z, coordinates of the point p. This is the point p in space. So this x, y, z, this distance, you see this distance is the x coordinate, y coordinate, and z coordinate of this point. Thus, if x, y, z is a point in space, then the position vector of that point is xi plus yj plus zk, where I, j, k are the unit vectors along the positive directions of the x, y, z axis. X, y, z axis. E, x, y, z, any point in space. Then the position vector with respect to the origin, position vector of that point is xi plus yj plus zk. That's also important. Okay? That's all.